Good morning, everybody. Greetings to all my listeners. I am Dr. Aarti, an Ayurveda Acharya. Today is our webinar on lifestyle as per Ayurveda. Now, what do you mean by lifestyle? So in general case, meaning of lifestyle define the way people live their life or the way we spend our typical day. Now, we will see the definition of good health. Well, good health is something everyone is expecting and looking for. These days, people have got a very conscious about their health, which is very positive factors. May it be young kids to aged people, every age a person should maintain their health by themselves or under assistance, because health is wealth for everybody. People are health conscious nowadays, and as I said, health conscious people are interested in good nourishment that can help in healing and health. Nourishment plays very important role in maintaining a good health. In case of any illness or weakness in body, a proper nourishment is the biggest supporting system. In fact, we are what we eat. Even the art of holistic healing, that is Ayurveda, teaches us that food and diet can make a vital contribution to good health. No prime thing as to food and diet to maintain healthy life is our lifestyle. Now, here for everyone, there are three important components of your health. The first one is this physiological part. This is related to our physiological body. Our lifestyle and our food intake directly creates an impact on our physiological body. Second is psychological factor. This factor is affecting the most to your health. It can be an unseen factor, but should not be overlooked. What you think, believe and feel affects your psychological or physiological health as well. Third is spiritual. Now, for many people, spirituality is still a question, but science has proved that in many ways, science and spirituality are interrelated. I would say spirituality is like a supporting system, physiological as well as your psychological health. Spirituality, in simple words, is to bring out the positivity and to stay positive. Now, health definition as per Ayurveda. We have very holistic sloka, which is Samadosa, Samagni, Samadhatu, Malakriyaha, Prasanna Atma Indriya Manaha Swastha Iti Abhidhiyate. What is good health? Now you can see on your screen, but I have mentioned three dosas, dhatus, malas, and also you can see one more factor, which is Indriya. There are three dosas. Now you all are knows that there are one is vata. Vata is air, pitta is fire, and third is kapha, is like mucus. Now you can see dhatus. Dhatus are the building structure of our body. There are overall seven such dhatus. First is a ras. Ras is a fluid of our body. Second is rakta, which is blood. Mansa, which is fleshes. Then medha, which is fat. Ki is the bone. And majja, which is bone marrow. And sukra. Sukra is related to the body's reproductive system. Now looking to malas, which are residues and waste material of the body. They are mutra. Mutra is the urine. Mala. Mala is the stool. Akshimala, that is riyam, which is eye discharge, that removes waste product which can be potentially harmful for eyes. It can be crusty, dry, sticky or wet. Karnamala is the ear wax. Nabhimala. Nabhimala is navel line wax. But here I would like to say my listener to remember, if you see any kind of such particle in dry or semi-dry form, then please do not remove it or prick it with your nails, or even don't try to remove it forcefully with your fingers or hands, as this can lead to infection. It is the natural process, hence it will come out naturally without any efforts. Just maintain the hygiene of the body by properly wiping after your bath, or in case of any septic or pus observed in the navel button, you must contact an expert or doctor. Nasa is a mala, it's a nasal discharge. Nail is bone's waste. Now here Indriya means senses. First we will see Gyanendriya, which are the well-known five sensory organ of the our body, that are eyes, nose, ears, skin and tongue. And second is Karmendriya. These are the working organs of the body, which are also five. They are the mouth, because it performs an action of chewing and speaking. Second are feet. Third is hand. These are also vital organs for performing many of our daily actions. Fourth is the anus, and fifth is genital organs, which are also very vital organs to keep our daily activities in balance. Now, we will discuss that the factors that affect our health. The first factor is always doshas, vata, pitta and kapha. Second is improper eating habit. This is one of the important factor affecting everyone in today's fast-paced life. Here, not only talking about excessivity, but also eating less food. Food with improper nutrition, improper intake of fluid and even odd times. Eating food which are contradictory in tendencies. Improper time schedule also affect lot to our health. In time of season, I mean to say that you must eat in accordingly to the season. I will discuss this in coming up slides. Now, exercise. Exercise regularly is must for everyone. I would like to suggest that if you are still beginner for exercise, then start with the comfortable period of the time and reach to 40 minutes at least. If further would like to say that at the age of 40, 40 minutes exercise is must, and that will lead to our body aging in a healthy and gracious way. Overall, you should have a balanced lifestyle. This is though hidden but extremely an important factor for maintaining good health. Here I mean psychological health, which will further lead to physiological health. Overall, keep your relation and emotion attached with them clear and transparent. And last but not least, meditation and well-being for the maintenance of positivity leading to good health. Now, lifestyle as per Ayurveda. Again, there is one sloka. Dinacharya Nisacharya Rutucharya Yathoditam Purusah Samvyavharan Sada Tishtati Na Anyatha. If you follow these three, Dinacharya, so daily routine, Ratricharya and Rutucharya. First we look Dinacharya. Dinacharya is a daily routine activities that you perform during the daytime. Second is Ratricharya. Ratricharya is for maintaining healthy physical relation with your partner and performing sexual activities only with each other willingness, which will hold the values of emotions and relation at the same time. And third, it's the Rutucharya, which are seasonal changes in lifestyle, which I will be explained one of the following slides. Now, Dinacharya. It's a daily routine. In this slide, I would like to explain that we perform most of the time during the day. So here are some quick tips. First is wake up time and proper method to waking up. Here I would like to say that Ayurveda suggests that one should wake up in Brahma Murat, which is approximately 4:30 a.m. or in other words, wake up the dawn breaks. Scientifically, this is the time when your brain power, the digestive system and the bowel movement are most active. In case if you cannot wake up so early, then waking up at least with the sunrise is preferable. Second is teeth care, dental hygiene. Dental hygiene is one most important thing that we must take care of. It is gargling. Gargle is also very important to improve the blood circulation in your gum and mouth, and also to remove any leftover impurities or particles after brushing. Saucha is a bowel movement, waste of our body that generated by post-digestive activity. Snana, which is bathing, no matter which season it is, but the body will throw out impurities and toxic through perspiration and or in the form of dead skin. This has to be removed daily by taking a proper bath. Now exercise, as mentioned earlier, exercise is very important, but taking proper adequate amount to rest is equally important for the body. Next is sleep. Sound sleep is very important for your psychological and physiological health. And last is an important, and it's a diet. So now a brief about diet management. Your diet should consist on daily nutrition. Proper balance of nutrition in body plays a vital role to maintain your health. Drink enough water. At least 12 glasses of water in a day is must. But an added and important tip, always try to sit and drink water. The water pass to system in a proper way. Seasonal diet is an important to maintain our health. Every season has its own tendency. Our body have diet through 3 meals. One is breakfast, next is lunch, and last is dinner. I must say that the midtime hunger should be taken care of by having fruits or fluids. Now, moving to Brahmacharya, or it's a Ratricharya. Brahmacharya, abstinence. Abstinence is not practical to have total abstinence, but at time maintaining abstinence will also keep you mentally and physically healthy. Brahmacharya is told as one among the 3 pillars of life. The ojas, essence of immunity, is told as by product of sukra. Here I mean that when you are fatigued, stressed, or are in upset state of mind, then in these cases, connecting yourself with your partner emotionally is more preferably than going for an intercourse, which can lead to more loss of energy in that state of mind. Brahmacharya leads to multifold improvement in concentration, memory, and courage. This is very important factor to understand generation. Students, teenagers, and children has many important roles to play in their life. Maintaining abstinence in case of having partner in their life is mandatory, so that later on they don't suffer problems like insecurity, companionship syndrome, depression, weak memory, or even will prevent them from falling a prey to evil practice of society. Having sex is not bad, but the willingness, right age, and right period of the time plays very important role. Brahmacharya imbibes reliability, strength in character, and trustworthiness. Brahmacharya is the energy for spiritual journey, which I explained earlier also. Now, he knows Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda was able to memorize whatever he used to glance in a book. By reading a few lines of paragraph, he used to get the meaning of the rest of all paragraph. To say that if one practice absolute abstinence for the period of 12 years continuously, a special nadi, it's a now power called Medha Nadi. Medha is the intelligence nadi developed in one's brain, which leads to tremendous memory and concentration. Now come the most important factor, which is Rutucharya. Routine as per, first you can see it's a Hemant. Hemant is early winter. In this season, you must have a routine food as you can see in the table. You can have sweet but in appropriate quantity. Sour and salty taste food can be easily digested in this season. Your digestive system can be enough active to digest heavy food also. During this season, light oil massage are also recommended. Now next is Shishira. Shishira is a winter. In this season, you must avoid pulses as it can be evoke vata in the body and that is gas, gastric problem. But again, you can have sweet and salty food. In winter, oil massage and sun bath are also recommended. If you don't have to expose your body to sunlight, then at least take time to expose your body for sunlight whenever it possible. Now Vasanta. Vasant is a spring. This is a beautiful season. In other words, it is a transitional phase from winter to summer. During this season, you are advised to have dry and roasted food. Adding salt to your diet is advisable, but in this season, you have to switch from sweet taste to consuming to bitter taste food. You can add at least one or two items, bitter taste food, in your daily diet. You should consume light food, and now in this season, since the sun rays are too strong, sunbath is not recommended. That only every morning sun rays are beneficial in the season. You can take early morning sun rays. Grisma. Grisma is the summer. In this season, you can add some sweet and cool food and fluid in your diet. Cold food or fluid. You can add like ice cream and cold juices. Your diet to maintain proper health and glucose level in your body. One must remember to consume enough amount of fluid and water. Here you may consume ice cool food and fluids to beat the heat, but remember not to have ice cool food soon after coming from hot sun. You may have to wait for at least 15 minutes to cold food product after coming from the sun. In this hot season, Shasthi Sali Pinda massage is advisable. This is a soothing massage which contains cow's milk, specially produced rice and few herbs. This will be cold and soothing to your skin and body. Now next is Varsha, means monsoon. When all doshas are aggravated, that is vata, pitta and kapha. Hence, you are advised to have light food and consume foods like honey and rice. Sour taste. You can add sour taste food is also beneficial and a treatment of vasti karma. That is the unique treatment of Ayurveda. It's a panchikarma. Panchikarma and here one treatment of panchikarma called vasti karma. Vasti karma has proven very beneficial in this season. The last is sarada, which autumn. During this season, you have to maintain a balance in sweet, bitter and pungent tasting food. You may have cold fluids and food in the season, but you must settle limit and balance your diet. In this season, dry massage like powder massage are recommended. Now, move ahead with rhythm of doshas in the six rutus. Here, now we know three doshas, vata, pitta and kapha. Here, first we will discuss about the first dosha, which is vata. As you can see, in grisma, which is summer, the vata is the vata in the body will be accumulated. But in Varsha Rutu, which is monsoon, the vata will be aggravated. As finally, it will settle down in Sarad Rutu, which is autumn. Next is, you can say, the Pitta. Pitta dosa will accumulate in Varsha Rutu, which is monsoon. It will aggravate in autumn, which is Sharada. And finally, settle down in Hemant Rutu, which is early winter. And last tendency of dosa, we are discussing about kapha. Kapha will get accumulated during early winter, which is Hemant Rutu. it will get aggravated in Vasant Rutu, which is spring, and will settle down in Grishma Rutu, which is summer. Looking of the tendency, all these three doshas as per season, I advise to follow the Rutu Charya chart discussed earlier. This will balance your three doshas in your body, thereby keeping your health and lifestyle in control. Now we are going to discussing some amazing facts, which are attributes of three doshas. In other words, we will discuss the characteristic, metabolism and the build of a body of any human, which will be analysis through three doshas. This is a beautiful way anyone can observe easily. First, we will discuss the characteristic built of a person with Vata Prakriti. They are having light and dry hair and skin. They are generally have cold hands and feet. Such people have thin body, bit rough texture of skin. So you can see here, lean and thin body, thin and dry hair, dry and rough skin, and appetite a little bit irregular because it produces gas or gastric problem. Now next, we will discuss about Pitta Prakruti. Their body temperature is little hot and their digestion power is very good. They have sharp features, medium body frame, and fair and shiny skin. Also, you can see here, moderate built body, early thinning and graying of hair, reddish pale structure, and their appetite, so they can have anything. Next, we move to Prakruti. Such people have heavy bone structure. They look a bit muscular and slightly overweight. Body temperature cools down very slowly. They have a large and stout body frame. Such people have smooth and fair skin. Here also you can see body in figure also. Round, tall and heavy. Hair is little bit thick, wavy and darker in color. Skin is oily, soft and smooth. And appetite is normal. Next Prakruti is Dvandaja, which combination of either of the two doshas from three doshas. And hence the discuss characteristic body build and skin textures are combination. You can see there is a Vata Pitta Prakruti, Vata Kapha Prakruti or Pitta Kapha Prakruti. Prakruti means body types. Last attribute is three dosa. A person who has having all three doshas, Vata, Pitta and Kapha. In such person, you can see no specific quality in particular because they have combination of all three doshas. Now, here we will understand the reasons leading to unhealthy body. To unhealthy body, there is a famous one Sanskrit sloka that we practice in Ayurveda, which is Hina Ati Mithya Sarva. Let me explain. First, I am going to explain hin, which is less. This is the myth that we should having less food can cut off fat and unhealthy body state. Anything less than required is equally harmful. Hence, one maintain a balanced diet in the routine. Fasting and starving are also strictly to be avoided if you want to be healthy. Next is ati. Ati is excessive and which is exactly opposite to hin. Hin is a less. Excessive intake of food, fluids and even more than requires amount of nutrition or nutritive supplements without prescription can also prove unhealthy and at a time dangerous for body. And last is mithya. Mithya means not in a state. To explain you more clearly, mithya is an unexpected seasonal or climatic changes during such state or condition. We must immediately daily routine and diet. I know you all are interested to learning about Ayurveda and yoga. Here, Param gives you chance to be AWC, AWP, YTT. Here you can see AWC is Ayurveda Wellness Counselor Program. In this program, one can understand Ayurveda theory and also principle of Ayurveda, prevention is better than cure. So how to prevent health? So AWC program focus on Ayurveda theory on prevention of health. I think you all heard about NAMA. There is a National Ayurved Medical Association for USA. AWC, AWP and YTT program also registered and approved program by NAMA. By this program, Param provides authentic and comprehensive Ayurvedic education. Graduate will be able to practice an Ayurvedic wellness counselor, offering client practice information on wellness and the prevention of the disease. This program duration is 1 year and 625 Param offers Ayurveda wellness counselor. See here AWP, which is Ayurveda Wellness Practitioner Program. This is also NAMA approved program. For this course or program, you must have certified or certificate of AWC, Ayurvedic Wellness Counselor Program, or any other equivalent program certification you can have. But if you are certified by these programs, here student can practice per their state laws or integrated into their own clinic works, teaching, wellness center or private practice. Graduates are trained in clinical assessment of the disease process, the pathways of disease and management protocol in different stage of disease. Who will be faculty? Param offers the premier faculty, doctors and specialists with experience in US and also from India. This program length is 1 year. So duration is 1 year and 1,000 hours program or 10 modules, hours of clinical internship. This is also NAMA approved program. You can learn by distance course also, distance learning, or you can come weekly for virtual classes and e-learning system. Now YTT, Yoga Teacher Training Program. Yoga Teacher Training Program, Param CARE gives two programs. One is 200 hours and here's the some program description. The program is divided into three segments. Segment A is deepening your asana, segment B is scaled life, and segment C is practical applications. Here student learn to integrate strength and energy, vinyasa as part of power, along with the study of basic Ayurvedic principle, again swasthya se swasthya rakshanam and aturasya vikara prasamanam cha. Support each individual's unique need. Here, candidates for 200 hours yoga teacher training certification program are required to have at least 6 month experience practicing yoga at any level. Same way here, yoga teacher training program for 300 hours. 300 hours advanced teacher certification is offered to those looking to take the next step in advancing his or her journey as a professional yoga teacher. You will be professional yoga teacher by attending this program. Student learn techniques to harness, dispense and channel their energy to heal themselves and impart this information to support the transformation of their students through group teaching. For 300 hours program, candidates must have successfully complete the 200 hours yoga teacher training certification program. That is Param Institute of Education offers an equivalent to before applying. 1st June, there's an International Yoga Day. So everybody interested in yoga, and you can learn by 200 hours or 300 hours yoga teacher training program. Here program length is 300 hours. So listener, guys, I have discussed many important factors to maintain a good lifestyle. I would like to share that I am going to discuss many more varieties of information in the next webinar, which will be on lifestyle and disease. Do's and don'ts, I'm going to discuss which are very helpful. Coming back to, I would like to share my references, Ashtanga Hridayam. These are our holy book, Charak Sanhita, then Harit Sanhita, Yog Ratnakar, Ashtanga Hridayam. If you are interested, that AWC, AWP, YTT 200, YTT 300, or any query, question, and health-related counseling, please contact on 732-383-5636. I repeat, 732-383-5656. Again, I repeat, 732-383-5656. And you can also write on info@paramcare.org, info@paramcare.org. And I would like to say, just click this slide, take a photograph for permanent, you can anytime contact. And I think you are interested in AWC, AWP, YTT 200, YTT 300, right? Thank you very much for taking time for this webinar.